this is the final team trying to punch their ticket to the national semifinals.
The Big Ten center of the year serving it up. We're underway. And a miss hit on the opening swing by Jordan Anderson finds the floor. So UCLA sides out right away.
And Jordan Anderson's such a creative player that it is a miss hit, but she is capable of doing that quite often. And look at this. That's what I was going to say. The team that starts off serving that ball top, taking some risks from the back line, are going to be in much better shape. Van Winden with a nice jump ace.
One of the top freshmen in the country this year. Both these teams won in four sets last night. Minnesota beating Missouri and UCLA taking out North Carolina. And there's Buschler. We were talking on the way over, Dane. Would Buschler be able to follow up what she did last night? Because that was a career match for her.
Absolutely. It was incredible. 19 kills, 24 digs for Buschler, trying to get her first 20-20 game. But that 20th kill just eluded her. But tonight, it looks like she has picked up exactly where she left off. She's already got a stuff block, and now chalk up kill number one. The big question, can Riley Buschler put the ball away against this Minnesota defense?
Buschler, the daughter of Judd Buschler, an All-American Arizona, played the NBA for 12 years, won national NBA titles with the Chicago Bulls, and now is an assistant with the Lakers. There she is again. And UCLA has started absolutely perfectly. A 5-0 run to start the match, and Minnesota burning a timeout. Again, Minnesota has won 35 straight. Last 3 points. Back to serve is Tori Van Winden, a first-team All-Pac-12 selection this year. One of the best freshmen, as I mentioned, in the nation. She has been one of the leaders on this UCLA team in just her first year. UCLA didn't see this coming, Dave.
No, you don't. You just never know what's going to happen. And if you're UCLA, this is a way to get over the early jitters if there ever was one. And finally, Minnesota gets on the board.
The service error by Van Winden. And Minnesota's won 35 straight in this building. The Sports Pavilion is fourth in the nation in attendance. Sarah Will Height, the Big Ten Player of the Year.
UCLA has to settle in. They've got this nice little cushion. Now it's about receiving serve, getting that ball in a nice settable position. That pass a little tight to the net.
That was Paige Tapp getting the kill. You'll hear the Tapp name a lot tonight. Her twin sister, Hannah, is also on the front line more often than not for Minnesota. Side out UCLA. Anderson going back to serve.
Back to serve is Anderson.
Anderson had 15 kills against North Carolina last night.
She found that small alley between Riley Buschler and the antenna.
Paige Tapp, a two-time first-team academic All-American, as well as a two-time All-American on the volleyball court. She and her sister set to graduate later this month. UCLA off the tip.
Interesting that that tip went down. You saw Minnesota trying to get a triple block in place. When you bring a triple block, that exposes you to the tip because no one is there to cover. And right there, UCLA took advantage.
North Carolina triple blocks as well. That's who UCLA beat last night.
Trying to maybe be a little bit too aggressive in that one-on-one situation as a blocker.
Buschler with 3 kills already. Here it is again. Extends over the net. Katie Shaw serving, a chemical engineering major, academic All-Big Ten performer.
Interesting. stuff straight down. She turned as the huddle came together. She said, that doesn't matter. I'll work it out here. It doesn't matter. So she knows what to do. She hit over 400 last night, and it's very rare that she gets blocked.
Heart stuffing her.
So far, UCLA maybe passing the ball just a little bit too tight to the net. It's caused them a couple of problems so far.
After a 6-0 start, Minnesota's pulling within two. Bussler with her fourth kill already of this opening set. Bussler was so impressive against North Carolina last night. 19 kills, a career high, 24 digs. Off a slide. That is the other Tapp sister, Hannah Tapp. Our first look at Hannah.
Entering the match and now serving number five.
First team All-American last year.
Tapp, we should call them the slide sisters because they both run that slide so well and get that ball to the floor so effectively. Second opportunity. UCLA has to be careful. Remember last night they got in that groove of tipping the ball too much. I'd like to see them be aggressive, take swings, and go for it.
That was perfect. Rosado with a nice serve receive.
Just beautiful all the way around for UCLA. Look at Formico with a back flipper with a right hand. Then Riley Bushler gets a dig. And then it's Jordan Anderson with an even sharper angle than we saw Van Winden earlier.
Formico, the two-time hero of the year in the Pac-12. There's a good dig by Miller.
Minnesota, but what UCLA is doing, they are keeping the ball alive, and that has been the difference. Look at this pancake right here. Kylie Miller extending, making it look easy.
UCLA, a very scrappy team. It's tough to put the ball away against them. This is Rosado for Dolly Santana, that is such a huge star here in Minnesota. She's a childhood friend of Santana's from Puerto Rico.
Minnesota's in good position, but they are getting tooled quite often. The ball seems to be just bouncing in the favor of the Bruins so far. Been a little bit frustrating early on for Minnesota.
Ryan Chandler, her father, Chris Chandler, who played quarterback in the NFL for 17 seasons. And she's also the granddaughter of NFL quarterback John Brody. Chris Chandler here this weekend. UCLA continues to pour it on.
It's spectacular plays, though, in the backcourt. Formico with another great dig, and then a creative play by Jordan Anderson, kind of off-speeding into the back line.
UCLA hitting 304 here, only 10 kills, 3 errors. A nice cerebral shot. Unfortunately, it didn't work out. That ball rolled along the top of the net and went out. But the attempt was good. A second timeout taken by Minnesota as UCLA in the midst of a 5-1 run. Tonight, they fell to UCLA in 4 sets. UCLA, the number 10 seed in the NCAA tournament. North Carolina was the number 7 seed. UCLA, courtesy of Van Winden. interesting game because Minnesota coming into the tournament, you have to say, the hottest team in the country. They beat Nebraska and Wisconsin on this court in the last week of the regular season. Minnesota, in fact, is actually ranked number one in the nation. They got the number two seed.
Yeah, I think justifiably so because of what you just said, beating Wisconsin, beating Nebraska in that final week. They actually won four matches in five sets. Pretty incredible. Right there, UCLA getting a stuff block, but it is ruled just out of bounds. So it's going to be point to Minnesota. But right now, you know what? It seems like the Bruins, they don't care that this team on the other side of the net is ranked number one, as they shouldn't. And they have silenced this crowd so far. They have really initiated everything that's happened.
Minnesota just has not lost on this court in a couple of seasons. It's such a fun atmosphere to be part of as Anderson gets the kill there. UCLA up 16-9. I mean, if you could script a perfect start for UCLA, this is it.
This is absolutely it. Even better than maybe you have scripted it, because now that you know they have a nice cushion right here. They're up by six, and Coach Mike Seely knows how to close. He's a great closer. It's just a matter of getting the players to believe that they can really take it to Minnesota. But you are absolutely right, Sam. Minnesota is an intimidating force, and they will get going sooner or later.
Minnesota last night had 11 kills. Here's her first tonight.
Boheit had never won a postseason award. She's a senior and won the Big Ten Player of the Year this year.
And again, that she had been on the same team with Dolly Santana for a few years as well. Boy, UCLA has tapped. Misfiring on that attempt.
The pace tap trying to do a bit of a severe line shot right there. When you go for the line, there's just a lot of room for error.
Minnesota only getting 0-42 in this opening set. Page tap hammers it.
She got up big right there. She knew exactly what to do. And that's what Minnesota has to do. Take advantage of any little opportunities they get. She crushes that one deep in the court.
Tapro takes back to serve. She has a 3.883 GPA at the prestigious School of Management, a marketing major. Again, a two-time first-team academic All-American. Only the fourth Minnesota player ever to be named that.
Kelly Lawless on that last play hit a beautiful pass and set. She hit it just wide, and you just cannot afford to do that. You have to make Minnesota earn the points. You cannot afford to give them anything. That's what I'm talking about, Sam, right there. That's okay. They earn that point. They jump into the angle. They make it happen. But right now, Minnesota is starting to close the gap. A huge block up at the net there.
A 5-1 run being enjoyed by the Gophers. That was Hart getting that block. An all-freshman Big Ten performer this year from Independence, Missouri. Mom was a basketball player at Oklahoma. She's the North Region Freshman of the Year. I wish I could reach out and bring you all in this building right now.
Yeah, it's electrifying. One of the most exciting volleyball venues in the nation to watch a match, and it has been impressive. The crowd showing up early, not to mention it is close to zero outside. It's about 5 degrees with, four to five inches of snow, but that does not faze any of these fans.
Well, the winner will move on to face Stanford, who upset Wisconsin earlier today. The NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship coverage continues with the national semifinals Thursday, December 15th at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. For more information on the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship, visit NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. So, you know, Dane, Stanford of the Pac-12 goes to Wisconsin and beats the Big Ten Badgers. We're seeing a repeat here. The Bruins coming in representing the Pac-12. Can they take out the Big Ten's Minnesota Golden Gophers?
They absolutely can if they continue to play this way. You know, Stanford, not a big surprise to me. I've always been talking about how strong that team is all year. So they are going to be in that national semifinal at UCLA, trying to represent the Pac-12 as well and get their ticket.
Ends the Minnesota run and extends the UCLA lead back to four.
That was a nice crush on the right side. As I said earlier, it's difficult to go down the line and be accurate. That ball executed right on.
Whistler's mom was a fantastic setter in Arizona, still ranks in the Wildcat top 10 in assists and digs.
Last night she hit 511 kills, trying to have a similar type of production here tonight.
Hannah Tapp hitting the kill. Minnesota within two. And Whistler again, what makes her so good? Come on, I mean, she has been making quite an impression these last two nights.
Well, number one, look in her eyes. She's very focused, and she is quite the athlete. Gets that ball, swings to the left, and she's prepared on every play. That's what makes her so effective.
Alexis Hart last night. She's a dynamic freshman as she rotates out. She is going to make a huge impression here for Hugh McCutchen over the course of her career at Minnesota. The lead remains two.
Freshman comes out like that, Mike Hart. She is going to be something special because she's so physically strong and knows the game so well. Double contact, our first double contact, I believe, of the night, and a good call. That ball just did not come out cleanly and was contacted twice.
You saw the UCLA bench over there. That's one trademark that we noticed. They are a very loose bunch. In fact, in the introductions, when UCLA was introduced and some of the fans booed a little bit and then erupted, for Minnesota, Formico looked next to her at Ryan Chandler and said, "This is awesome."
That's what you want. You want, I mean, you're in a hostile environment. You have to really feed off the energy of the crowd and embrace the situation.
That is Will Hite stuffing.
Spectacular start, but we knew that Minnesota would get on track and start to play to their potential, and they have closed the gap.
Wow. 20 all. Now we got a game to five to take this set, and the pressure has turned. The crowd has started to get involved.
UCLA had silenced them up until now. But right now, the momentum has swung to Minnesota.
The 26th ace of the season for Rosado. We're tied at 20.
Taking charge. Check out Samantha Seliger-Swenson, the Big Ten setter of the year, jousting Setters take pride. She's the last one to touch it, pushes over the net, wins against the two blockers, and she's got her team really on fire.
Again, Seliger Swinson 5-11. Claire Felix is 6-6. And Seliger Swinson wins that battle.
You know, usually the shorter player wins because of leverage. It was always a big thing when I was playing winning and losing jousts. You never wanted to lose one. And a lot of times the setters have a lot more experience in jousting than a middle. And that's why you see them victorious more often than not.
Hugh McCutcheon, National Coach of the Year last year, took this team to the national semifinals. Took the U.S. Men's Olympic team to a gold medal in the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing, and then a silver medal with the women's team in London. But if he can win the national championship, he will have won an Olympic gold medal as a head coach and a national championship as a head coach at the collegiate level. And that's a very rare air, isn't it, Dana? Guy very near and dear to your heart is the only man who's ever done that.
Yeah, Marv Dunphy at Pepperdine University. He's got four national championships, and he won as coach of the 1988 men's Olympic team, bringing home the gold medal. I learned a lot from him and continue to learn a lot from him to this day. And speaking to Hugh McCutcheon, he said that Marv Dunphy, a big influence in his coaching, as well as Carl McGowan, a former BYU coach, and Doug Beal.
It's going to be Anderson or Bushler at this point. And that was Anderson.
Yeah, you want to go to those players who are extremely confident in these situations. And it's going to be very important in terms of setting. You got Ryan Chandler in, who is serving now. She will be quarterback in this team in this very crucial situation.
Pavilion magic comes through, and the Gophers are up a set.